always remain loyal, not just to me, but to the manager, head coach, striking coach.
Of course, of course. Right. People, like, we're just here to chat shit, aren't we? This is not a fault. Yeah. Like, people always think, like the grass, this will be an almost joke. People always think, like, the grass is greener on the other side, and, like, move coaches, move teams, and anything that. And one thing about Conor, mate, through all the bullshit, whatever he's done or whatever, he stayed loyal to his team, he stayed loyal to his manager, and he's never not given you an interview, mate. So you have to give him props for that. And I've seen that before, man, when you was giving him the interview. So big up to Conor, because I try to live by the same sense. Like, you have people in your ears and they're like, you know, maybe you should go here or do this or go with that guy or speak. And it's like, believe in the process. And Conor has definitely done that. And listen, okay, he's had a loss or two. I've had my loss or two, but he's at the top, mate. He's still at the top.
You have dealings with him? Like, do you have a relationship with him? You have a relationship with him?
Yeah, do you know what? For the first time the other day, I spoke to Aldi. I don't know how to pronounce his proper name. How do you pronounce his Spanish name? Aldi, yeah. He seems like a nice guy. Obviously, I'm MTK normal till I die. Management, but... he seems cool. He was, you know, just chatting back and forth. He was like, yes, Till, you know, big fan of that. And I was like, it's right, mate, good luck on the fight, whatever. He was out in Dubai at the time. But no, I don't have no dealings, but I see a lot of... Obviously, Instagram's very... It's not real, is it? But you see a lot of things what goes on. And he's with his team, he's with his manager, and he's never not give you an interview, mate. And there's three things I see with what that guy's... You know what I mean? People look like... Right now, I know Poirier. I get on with Poirier great. And you know what? He's a working class, you know. And I would love to see him win the fight. I'd love to see... Like, he's a great in my eyes. But just the amount of people shitting on Conor right now, it just grinds me gears. And I just think I'd love to Conor just to win, just to shut all these people up and go and get that title. One last hurrah, because it's just so fickle how people change, isn't it, Ariel? It's so fickle.
Like, you feel like they're rooting against him in Europe?
Not necessarily in Europe. Like, I don't see it like that. I just see it sort of like, I don't know. People are just looking at the last fight and then saying, this guy's a bum or this guy's this. And then I like to go back in time and look at, not even like the title fights. I like to look at like the vibes and like, you can't forget that type of shit, you know what I mean? Not a lot of people have done that, you know. So, I've actually got a video on this phone now here. You remember that? Do you know a while back the mental fighter who was getting hit in the back of the head in boxing? Do you ever remember that?
Yeah.
And he's a cabbage now, isn't he? Ariel, like, he's not okay. And I've got a video on the phone, and it's so sad to see about the guy, and it's like, you got to respect every man that steps in there, especially a man who stepped in there and got to the top by Conor.
Yeah. Is it coming home, Darren?
Yeah. Not now, it's not. Fucking can't get fucking tickets off me, Jake. Fuck me,
Are we like best friends now? Are we colleagues now? Let's get real, because I am BT Ariel. I'm working for the number one UFC broadcaster worldwide. We're not just talking UK now. We're talking worldwide.
I've got a text on my phone that's from last year that says ESPN MMA is the best. So what's going on, Ariel?
No. We got the great Dan Hardy, the great Michael Bisping, Caroline Pierce, Adam Catterall, Nick Pete. We've got a phenomenal team, and the behind-the-scenes team is even better, if you ask me.
Oh, yeah.
So, am I, like, an honor freshman now?
I mean, BT showed me a lot of love. So, I suppose we are colleagues. I suppose